You're watching KDKA-TV News at 6 in high definition.
We continue to monitor the courthouse in Bellefonte in Center County. That is where the jury is now trying to decide whether Jerry Sandusky is guilty of child sex abuse. The world now waits to hear what that jury decides, but perhaps no one has a better idea of what could happen than those who have been there.
So what do spectators think could happen next? Trina Orlando continues our live team coverage now from Center County. Trina.
Susan, people came from near and far here to the Center County Courthouse today to hear those closing arguments, but they weren't just watching the attorneys, they were also watching members of the jury, the group of people who are now deciding Jerry Sandusky's fate. Jerry Sandusky's fate is now in the hands of a Center County jury, a group of 7 women and 5 men who have listened to a week and a half of testimony that concluded with closing arguments this morning.
Not a lot of body language. They were trying to have I thought a poker face, trying to be very in tune and really focused on what the conversation that was being told.
Also keeping an eye on the jury was Tom Klein, the attorney for victim number 5.
I thought they were largely dispassionate. Some of the jurors who have been proficient note takers throughout were taking some notes. A lot of the jurors just sat and watched, essentially dispassionately.
Jerry Sandusky is now facing 48 counts of child sex abuse. Defense attorney Joe Amendola told jurors this morning that the accusers were coached into their stories and questioned their motives. Prosecutor Joseph McGinnigan attacked Sandusky, saying he behaved like a serial predatory pedophile.
And I believe that their reactions were mixed, because obviously the majority of them are affiliated to Penn State in one way or another. I believe that the jury, though, will make the best decision to their knowledge, and I'm hoping that justice is served in this case.
Judge John Cleland stressed to the jury that it's not necessarily a crime to touch a child, and they must carefully consider Jerry Sandusky's intent when distinguishing between innocent affection and lust.
This jury looked like a jury who knew the case, watched the case, understood the case, and was ready to, in lawyer parlance, get the case.
And the jury is right now on a dinner break from 6 to 7 o'clock. They will then come back and continue their deliberations. We've heard from the judge that he will let the jury deliberate through the weekend if it takes that long. In the meantime, they will be sequestered if their deliberations carry into tomorrow, which means when they're finished at the courthouse tonight, they will be taken to a hotel where they will have no access to email or their cell phones. For now, we are live in Bellefonte Center County. Trina Orlando, KDKA TV News.
Trina, thank you.